Yeah, thank you. Thank you. On all other days, I would talk about our AIP prowess, our foundry, our maybe even our government products, and there's some things I'd like to say there, and welcome, obviously, all of you, 111 of you presenting actual things done in Palantir products. We have our leader of our retail movement here, which is important, but this, for whatever reason, this was scheduled right before probably the largest event that has ever happened to our company. And we've had some pretty interesting events. You know, first of all, we survived. Most Silicon Valley companies do not survive. We focused on how institutions ought to run and build software products around that, starting with clandestine services, moving into spec ops, moving into the battlefield, moving into commercial. And these products have materially changed the course of society. We DPO'd, which is a fancy way of saying we didn't give the bankers all the money. We transferred it to loyal individual investors, which is part of the reason we have so many supporters. And yet, no one thought we would be profitable on a free cash flow basis or that we'd be GAAP profitable. And the idea that we could be in this exclusive club of the S&P 500 was something that, believe me, everyone internally is like, okay, Alex, just shut up about this idea. This is too much. No way we're going to get this to work. And it worked. And for us, this is just like at Palantir, this is arguably the biggest event that has happened to us because, you know, it's just, you are actually a real serious company. And it was done on the back of products that are powerful enough that we could keep our company the same size and increase the number of partners we have and the revenue. So, and I would say, while getting on the S&P, we stayed true to our values. That's kind of obvious and sometimes annoying to our partners because we have to speak about certain truths that maybe aren't popular, but it doesn't make them less true. But we also have the very best partners in the world. Palantir, over a course of 20 years, there have been two things that have been true. We have the very best people. The Palantir degree now is the most important degree in tech, bar none. People now have to make sure we get people or mission aligned because we have so many people just want to join so they can become famous. And then we've had the very best partners. I hate the term clients, but de facto clients. And obviously, we could go through the government clients we're allowed to acknowledge, and they are the most elite and interesting in the world. But I would say our commercial partners, as witnessed here, and the people presenting, are the most interesting, most dynamic, most, in general, highest integrity commercial partners that you will ever meet. The people running them who've purchased our products, the people who are supporting the people running in and doing their own thing in IT, engineering, production, marketing, have one thing in common, which is I need my business to work better, and I'm going to look at the product, and I'm not going to look at the steak dinner. And that's how we ended up with the best people and the best customers and the best use cases. And, of course, that is just a massive structural advantage. And that was an advantage before you got to AI. What is the large language model? By the way, as a kind of non sequitur, I'm not sure what the person, our partner from US government's gonna say today, because I didn't even know we were allowed to talk about the stuff, but I'm really excited that we can have a vignette into that. We'll see what we're allowed to know. But that's super cool. But then if you have this revolution, large language and algorithmic, in the U.S. government, it's more, in general, more algorithm than large language model. But it is a weird revolution because it's in a normal revolution, you have lots and lots of startups, and they get one or two get all the value. In this revolution, you have the large language models and AI have to be processed in an enterprise, and what that basically means is enterprises with high business acumen and high talent can raise their game and become essentially the startup that would have disrupted them and disrupt the startups. So it's like an incredible time to be you, and arguably not as good a time to be a venture investor. It's like, it's great to be us, it's great to be you, because The intermediate of large language models is how do you process them? How do you fix your margins? How do you turn your company into a portfolio? How do you understand where the risk allocation is, the capital allocation? How do you turn your non-engineers into engineers? How do you disrupt the distribution? How do you make up for distribution while distribution has capital costs? The nature of political uncertainty disrupts your products. All these things are solvable in with our product, your business acumen, your data, your way of going to business, and it, you can accelerate them. And it's that acceleration that is going to drive the, our partners to what I view is going to happen to us, which is become stronger, bigger, more successful, and actually happier, because you do not want your best workers working on things that they don't enjoy, that there's no point in doing, where they're not productive, where they can't prove the results, where the margin changes aren't actually showing up on the bottom line. And all those things are possible with our product and with you. And it's just an incredibly exciting time. But again, the most exciting thing for me, and I'm very happy to have you guys here, where this is probably going to be an AIPCon that's part work, and quite frankly, you may see them partying. Surprised they're even awake. You know, it's like, you know, Palantirians don't really get the opportunity to party. High school didn't work. No one would party with us. College, you were busy trying to get into Palantir. And then you have to work and work, and we had a DPO, but no one really thought that was going to work. So there was so much of a surprise that there was no partying. So now, you know, if they're slightly slower, slightly inebriated, forgive them. Enjoy the vibe. It's a rare time for us, and we're going to be back to crushing it with less alcohol and other things. We don't. It's like sex, drugs, and rock and roll, but we don't really have any of them. But we do have a great product. It's a great product. You don't need any of that stuff. The product makes up for it. It's the size of the product that matters. So, any case, with that, welcome to what I think will be a really cool time. I am exceedingly happy to have you here. I'm exceedingly happy currently just in general because of the SMP mission and other things and having you and having 111 people actually show things that are working. And I hope you have a good time and come back. Take care.